Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. Initially, we have did a theory which was based on postulates of kinetic theory of gases, and also we have did various law on the ideal gas equation. So regarding all this thing, we are now going to study a new thing known as kinetic gas equation. So what is this? Let us know about it. So basically, kinetic gas equation is nothing but a mathematical gas equation derived from the basic postulates of kinetic energy of gases, and from which all the gas law can be deduced, is called as kinetic gas equation. So now, initially we have did a theory which was based on postulates of the ideal gas, or the kinetic theory of ideal gases. In that, various postulates we have did, that is most 8 points that we have did, that what is the postulate of kinetic theory of a gas. And based on that also, we have also studied that what are the ideal gas equations. So because this kinetic gas equation is related to basically the velocity of the gas particles that are in a fixed volume, and as you know that the velocity of the gas remains constant throughout all the in a particular volume, but all the gas particles will not have the same kind of velocity, because they would have different mass, they would have different velocity also. Suppose if a gas is been accompanied by various different gases, or a volume of a particular container consists of various different gases, then it would have different mass, as well as since we are talking about different mass, they will have different velocities also. So this implies that if the temperature will increase, then the velocity will also increase. But yes, it also depends on the mass. So basically, the kinetic gas equation is related to the velocity of the gas particles that we are going to learn now. So now it has been represented by PV is equals to 1 by 3 mn u square, and this PV is nothing but the pressure of the gas that has been kept constant in the throughout the whole container, while V is the volume of the container in which the gas has been kept. And let us talk about that, what is the term mn and u. So as we have said earlier also, that P is basically the pressure that is exerted by the gas molecules, and it would be in the fixed volume of a particular container. While V is nothing but the volume of the container, and the small n, it represents the number of molecules of gas that are being placed in that container, while small m is the mass of a gas molecule. It is the small m is basically the mass of a single gas molecules. So there would be n number of molecules that would be present in the volume there, in the volume of the gases, and where u is nothing but the root mean square velocity. So this is the thing where we have got to know, that is u is equals to root mean square velocity. But what is actually root mean square velocity? So for that, we have the root mean square velocity is nothing but it is the square root of the mean of the square of the velocities of the molecules of a gas. So where if we consider that if n number of moles of gas or n molecules of gas has been present in a vessel, or has been present in a container, and let u1, u2 and u3 and going on extra till un are the velocities of n molecules, then what will happen is then we could analyze this thing as by writing the sum of the square of the velocity. How can we do that? We know, suppose if u1 is some a velocity of a particular gas molecule, so this is the sum of the square. What we have to do is we have to square the we have to sum up the square velocity. So therefore, this is u1 square, again it will go on till u2 square, again till un square. And as we know that suppose if we are taking the mean of it, so what will happen? So this is something where we will divide by n. So therefore, the sum of the square of the velocity of the gas divided by the n will become the basically mean square of the velocity. So we could write this as mean square of the velocity also. But we have to make the square root of it. So how can we write? So for that, we have this is C, this C represents basically the velocity of the gas molecules, and RMS is basically root mean square. So this was basically the root, this was basically the mean square, and we have summed it and we have made an average of it. So therefore this is nothing but we could also say it as the mean of square of velocity, because initially what we have did is we have added and then we have divided it by the number of n's. Now it is basically the mean of square of velocities. So we have to make a square root of it, so it would be very much easy to do. So we'll take the square root of this mean square itself, so therefore this would be written as u1 square plus u2 square, and it will go on till un square the whole divided by n. So this is nothing but root mean square velocity of a particular molecule which is present in a fixed volume of a container. So, but we have also derived today that or in this lecture, that is ideal, that is kinetic gas equation, which is nothing but PV is equals to half mv half m n u square. So let us talk about this thing in a very deep. So as we know, suppose if we contain n number of molecules and which has a particular velocity as u1 square, u2 square, and it will go on. So on that basis, that particular gas molecule will have a fixed mass. So that mass, suppose it has a mass of m1, m2, m3, and it will go on because they will have different mass in them. So based on this thing, we could write this equation as you know, PV is equals to basically 1 by 3 m n u square, and we know that the m is nothing but the mass of the mass of a particular gas, and n is the number of the gas molecules or the number of gas molecules that is present in the fixed container. So suppose what if I say that the number of gas molecules is nothing but the Avogadro number. So what will happen is if number of molecules of gas is equals to, or it if it contains one mole of a gas, then I'm saying that we have basically n a number of molecules, that is this Na is nothing but the Avogadro number, and it when it comes to the total number of Na molecules, then what we are saying it as, then this equation can be written as PV is equals to 1 by 3 small m into Na and u square. But if we know that if we multiply the mass multiply the mass with the Na, then what we would get, and since we are talking about one mole of gas, then this whole thing will be nothing but the molar mass of the gas. So therefore this whole thing can be written as PV is equals to 1 by 3 capital M. This capital M stands for the molar mass of the gas, and this is u square. So this is the first equation suppose we have got. And now what we are going to do is, and also we know that when it comes to an ideal gas equation, PV is equals to nRT. That is fine, but also we know that we are talking about one mole. Therefore, for one mole of gas, n is equals to 1. So I could write it as PV is equals to RT. So this is nothing but equation number 2. But initially we have got equation number 1 as 1 by 3 m dot u square. So I could relate this both two equations as. Now we have got two equations. So therefore what we are going to do, we are going to equating both equation 1 and. So we have got initially, we have got PV is equals to, that is 1 by 3 m u square, which was equation 1, And now we have also got PV is equals to R into T. This is equation number 2. So by equating this two equation, what we have got? We have got 1 by 3 M U square is equals to R T. Therefore, U will be basically 3 R T divided by, that is N. And since I am talking about U, I'm not talking about U square, so therefore this would be the square root. And this U is nothing but CRMS, or what we could say it as, which is nothing but square root of 3 RT divided by M. So this is what we have calculated, or what we have derived a formula where the root mean square velocity is equal to the square root of the product 3 RT divided by M. So this clearly indicates that suppose if c is the velocity of a particular gas, and if it is not the root mean square velocity of a particular gas, suppose it is a velocity of a gas. So this clearly indicates that this would be basically inversely proportional to the molar mass of that gas, or it could say it as, if the gas particles are very heavy, so the velocities are will be less because they are inversely proportional to it. So this equation clearly indicates that if the velocity of a gas is more in a particular pressure and a particular volume and having a particular temperature, then there is a possibility that the molecular mass of that would be less. Or if a particular gas that don't have a high velocity compared to that of the other one, and in the condition which it is been present, it has been at a constant pressure, a volume and temperature, so in that case the in that case the molar mass would be more compared to the other one. So this clearly indicates that the velocity depends on the mass of the molecule. So this was an equation which was based on kinetic equation of a gas. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood a clear concept of this. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.